for Melody Ranch and Gene Autry.
I'm back in the saddle again, out where a friend is a friend, where the longhorn cattle feed on the lowly jimson weed. I'm back in the saddle again.
That's right, folks. It's another visit with all the gang here at Melody Ranch. There's Pat Buttram, the Cass County Boys, the Gene Autry Blue Jeans, Carl Kottner's Melody Ranch Hardway 6, and yours truly, Charlie Lyon. Right now, though, meet the boss man himself, America's favorite cowboy, Gene Autry.
A gay ranchero, a caballero, can always find someone to pet. A senorita, a sweet papita, her other loves will soon forget. If he's insistent and she's not distant, the senorita will confess. Her gay ranchero, her caballero, need only ask and she'll say yes. Soon there'll be a fiesta with a blushing bride and a gay ranchero standing by her side. If they find the promise that they have in store, they'll be counting little chicos by the score. Back on this rancho, we now find Pancho with his Pepita by his side. She thinks he's handsome, worth any ransom. To him she's still a blushing bride. Our gay ranchero, our caballero, still tells the world of how they met. This gay ranchero, this caballero, says he has nothing to regret. Now to end the story that I once was told, here's a little secret that I must unfold. For they found the promise that they had in store. Now they're really counting chicos by the score.
Well, greetings, everybody, and welcome once again to Melody Ranch.
Have faith, hope, and charity. That's the way to live successfully. How do I know? The Bible tells me so. Do good to your enemies, and the blessed Lord you'll surely please. How do I know? The Bible tells me so. Don't worry about tomorrow, just be real good today. The Lord is right beside you, he'll guide you all the way. Have faith, hope, and charity, that's the way to live successfully. How do I know? The Bible tells me so. Have faith, hope, and charity, that's the way to live successfully.
How do I know?
The Bible tells me so. Do good to your enemies, and the blessed Lord you'll surely please.
How do I know?
The Bible tells me so. Charity, that's the way to live successfully. How do I know?
How do I know?
The Bible tells me so.
Well, thank you, Cass County Boys.
Hi, Mr. Artery.
Well, hi, Pat Buttram.
One, two, three, four. One, two, three.
Just a minute now, Buttram. What are you doing?
Oh, I'm practicing my new dance lessons. One, two, three, four. One, two, three.
Well, now, isn't that amazing? I'm proud of you.
You proud that I can dance?
That you can finally count up to four.
Now, don't go poking fun at me, Mr. Artery. I put a lot of work into my dance lessons.
I bet you did.
Yeah, for the past 6 months, I've studied dancing by mail.
Oh,
yeah.
How did it work out?
Well, the only one I could dance with was my mailman. Trouble is, his wife wouldn't let him out at night.
Oh.
But being the kind who never gives up, I started practicing my dancing lessons with a chair. Dancing with a chair, you know.
Uh-huh.
but I'm worried.
You mean your little mind is worried?
Yeah.
How come?
Where am I going to find a girl with four legs and a curved back?
You know, I've seen some of your dates, Patrick. And if there's one, you'll find her. But tell me this. What dances can you do?
Well, I'm real good at the turkey trot.
Well, anybody can do the turkey trot.
With live turkeys? But I'm doing so good in my lessons that I'm getting promoted. Starting this week, I get to dance with girls.
Oh, with girls.
You know, them's the ones that dance backwards.
Well, I certainly hope when you start asking the ladies for a dance that you do it right. Now you're supposed to say good evening, Mamselle. May we indulge in the art of thirpsichore?
No, I don't say that, no.
I don't either, very good.
No, I just
thirpsichore is the name of it.
All I say to them, I say, come on, tomato, get off of the vine and let's make a splash. But some of them girls at the Sagebrush Dance Land, I don't even like to ask them to dance. They're not very pretty, you know, some of them.
Oh, you mean they're wallflowers?
Mr. Ardrey, some of them have been wallflowers so long that they sprinkle them once a week. But we had a square dance last night. It was real great. The only trouble is the fellow that calls the dances, he also is a hog caller in the daytime.
Oh. Well, how does it work out?
It's the only dance where you can bring a girl and go home with a pound of bacon. It's a real high-class dance hall, though. They wouldn't let my mule in last night because he didn't have a necktie on.
Oh, real class, yeah. Huh? Well, tell me now, Patrick.
Huh?
What other dances can you do?
Well, let's see. There's the Missouri waltz,
mm-hmm,
and the Tennessee waltz, and now the Texas waltz.
Texas waltz. How do you do the Texas waltz?
Well, you take three giant steps, jump up in the air, and when you come down, you strike oil. So long, Mr. Ardrey.
So long there, Patrick. Oh, brother. Well, I guess if we keep trying to slick that boy up, why, we may be able to make a roughneck out of him yet.
Oh.
But, folks, make way for the Cass County boys and give them plenty of room to sing. Boys.
Busy man, the Lord is a busy man, a mighty busy man is he. But rain or shine, he's still got time to look out for you and me. Oh, the Lord is a busy man, the Lord is a busy man, a mighty busy man is true. So we are blessed with a day of rest, his labors are never through. He has to hang out the stars and shine up the moon, see that the birds keep on singing in June. It's a fact that the Lord is a busy man, the Lord is a busy man, a mighty busy man is he. But rain or shine, he's still got time to look out for you and me. Time to look out for you and me.
Yeah. Oh, nice going there, Cass County boys. Thanks a lot.
Sierra Sue, I'm sad and lonely. The rocks and rills are lonely too. Sierra Sue, I want you only, no one but you. Sierra Sue, the roses weep, their tears
are falling. The gentle doves no longer coo. Oh, can't you hear my sad heart calling, calling for you, Sierra Sue. Calling, calling for you, Sierra Sue.
Oh, thank you, gang. Thank you a lot. Say, Patrick. Pat.
I'm sorry, Mr. Artery.
Why, you seem to be a million miles away.
Well, I was just trying to think back about something. I caught a glimpse of a feller in sagebrush yesterday, and I know I seen him before, but I can't remember where. Drives you crazy.
Yeah, I know what you mean. I can recall one time that happened to me. As it turned out, it was a good thing. I remembered when I did, just in time to prevent a murder.
Hey, let's hear all about it, huh?
Well, it all happened a good many years ago, Pat. Because of bad health, Jim Duncan of the Circle D had been forced to sell his ranch. About a month after the new owner had moved in, I happened to run into Hank Porter, Jim's longtime foreman. Well, how do you like your new boss, Hank?
Okay, I guess. Mr. Stevens sort of dumped everything into my lap, Gene. Lets me run things any way I want.
Smart fella.
Yeah, he's an odd sort. Stays to himself most of the time, doesn't want to see anybody. Claims the only reason he bought the place was to get away from people, rest up.
Say, would that be your Mr. Stevens in the buckboard, driving toward the ranch?
Yeah, I'm supposed to go into town with him again. That's one thing I don't like about this job, playing nursemaid.
That's all?
He won't set foot off the ranch unless I'm with him. I feel like a hired bodyguard.
Looks like a mighty young man to be a retired businessman.
Uh-huh. That's something else I don't savvy about him.
Well, Porter, don't you think you've kept me waiting long enough?
Oh, sorry, Mr. Stevens.
Never mind excuses. Who's this?
Gene Autry owns Melody Ranch.
So, how do you do, Mr. Stevens?
Well, come on, Porter. Leave your horse at the gate and... Something wrong, Autry?
Well, excuse me for staring, but haven't we met somewhere before?
I hardly think so. Till I bought this ranch, I'd never heard of Hidden Valley.
Well, Gene's been around quite a bit, Mr. Stevens. Used to be a ranger.
Oh, a ranger?
Oh, that was a good many years back, Mr. Stevens.
Well, if we're going to get to town...
Never mind, Porter. Changed my mind. You go in alone. I'm going back up to the ranch. Get up! Get up!
Well, like I said, Gene, a funny guy. Never know from one minute to the next what he's going to do. You've been mighty quiet, Gene. Something on your mind?
Stevens. I'm sure I've seen him somewhere before.
Says he's from Colorado, only seems awfully interested in Kansas City lately.
What do you mean?
One reason we're going to town so often, to pick up the Kansas City papers.
Oh, off the road, Hank. Quick.
Shots came from back there, Gene, up on the ridge. Now, why would anybody be shooting at us?
Do you usually use the buckboard when you go into town with Stevens?
No, most of the time we take a saddle horse. Hey, wait a minute.
Mm-hmm. I'm about the same build. Somebody could have mistaken me for Stevens. Well, during the next few days, I couldn't shake off the feeling that there was something mighty familiar about Stevens, but I couldn't remember where I'd seen him. Then, toward the end of the week, I ran into him again. This time, he was at the depot in Sagebrush, talking to Pop Willis, the newsman. Well, hello, Mr. Stevens.
Huh? Oh, hello. See you tomorrow, Willis.
Yeah, so thing, Mr. Stevens. Not a very sociable crash, is it, then?
Seems annoyed about something.
Newspapers from Kansas City weren't on the afternoon train. I told him the only thing I could do was save them for him when he came in tomorrow.
Say, do me a favor, will you, Pop? Save one for me, too. It was a long shot, but I had a hunch that the answer I was looking for might be in one of those newspapers. The following day, I was waiting on the station platform when the train pulled in. That's when it happened again.
Something wrong, Gene?
Oh, hello there, Hank.
You staring at the fella that just got off that train. You know him?
Well, I do and I don't. Just like Mr. Stevens. I've seen that man before, but I can't remember where.
Can't figure what you expected to find in the news from Kansas City, Gene. You waded through them all half a dozen times back there at the depot.
I guess I just couldn't concentrate on the printed words, Hank. Uh-huh. I kept seeing the face of that fellow who got off the train.
I know how it is. Drives you crazy sometimes, trying to remember.
Mm-hmm. Hey, wait a minute. There was something in one of those papers.
Is this the one?
Yeah. Yeah, here it is. Story about the Bush gang.
Bank robbers? Got caught a while back, didn't they?
All but one. And Bush himself is still at large. Hey, listen to this, Hank. Ace Deegan, who managed to escape a police trap several months ago, is believed... That's it. Now we're getting somewhere.
Well, would you mind letting me in on it?
Ace Deegan. He's the man I saw get off the train.
What do you suppose he's doing in Sagebrush?
I just remembered something else. Where I've seen your boss, Stevens. Come on. We'd better ride over to the Circle, fast.
Yes, but... Deegan.
Hello, boss. Pardon me, Mr. Stevens. Easy, now keep your hands with you. Been a long time, ain't it, Bush, since you were supposed to meet us in Kansas City with the dough.
Now, look, you got me all wrong. I just had to lay low. Things got real hot.
Sure, and it got real hot for me and the rest of the boys when somebody tipped off the cops where to pick us up.
I had nothing to do with that, Deegan.
You wanted to get rid of us so as you could keep all the dough to yourself. But it took me a long time to find you, Bush. And now that I'm here...
All right, hold it, Deegan.
All right, get his gun, Hank.
Right.
And if he opens his mouth, we'll shut it up for him.
Well, Mr. Autry, looks like you got here just in time to prevent a mistake being made. That's what it was, you see. Big misunderstanding. Mr. Deegan here is a very good friend of mine.
He is, now, Mr. Stevens. Or should I call you Frank Bush?
What? What are you talking about?
Oh, skip it. I finally remembered where I'd seen your face before. On a wanted poster during my ranger service.
Okay. Well, look, can't we make a deal? I can make it worth your while, Autry.
I don't think so, Bush. But I tell you what I will do. Since Deegan here is a good friend of yours... I'll see if I can't arrange for you two to share the same cell together. Folks, I think the most unusual thing about our cowboy classic for today is the wonder that it was not written long before it was, because people have been looking for elbow room to live in ever since Daniel Boone started guiding the settlers westward from the Atlantic coast. Anyway, here is Don't Fence Me. Oh, give me land, lots of land under starry skies above. Don't fence me in. Let me ride through the wide open country that I love. Don't fence me in. Let me be by myself in the evening breeze. Listen to the murmur of the cottonwood trees. Send me off forever, but I ask you please, oh, don't fence me in. Just turn me loose. Let me straddle my old saddle underneath the western sky. On my cayuse, let me wander over yonder till I see the mountains rise. I want to ride to the ridge where the west commences, gaze at the moon till I lose my senses. Can't look at hobbles and I can't stand fences. Don't fence me in.
Just turn me loose. Let me straddle my old saddle underneath the western skies. On my cayuse, let me wander over yonder till I see the mountains rise.
I want to ride to the ridge where the west commences, gaze at the moon till I lose my senses. Can't look at hobbles and I can't stand fences. Don't fence me in.
Well, Mr. Artery, they always say cowhands are quiet and reserved, but the Melody Ranch gang certainly blossomed out at a party, don't they?
Well, that's because we're among good friends, Pat. So we forget about everything else but enjoying ourselves. Well, folks, I guess that's just about it for our stay in Milwaukee. And this is Gene Autry asking you to keep thinking of us until we're back in the saddle again. Out where a friend is a friend, where the longhorn cattle feed on the lowly Jimson weed, I'm back in the saddle again.
America's favorite cowboy, Gene Autry, will be back this way next week. And he'll bring along Pat Buttram, the Cass County Boys, the Gene Autry Blue Jeans, Carl Kottner's Melody Ranch Hardway 6, and yours truly, Charlie Lyon. For an exciting and entertaining half hour, be sure you're listening next time I say, it's time for Melody Ranch and Gene Autry.
This is the United States Armed Forces Radio and Television Service.